Welcome to Garden Chat. We are out here behind the children's garden with Herb Lewis. He's one of our sponsors of our birding trail. He's really the reason we're always talking about birds. He's really showed us what we have here at the garden is a real gem. But we've got a special treat behind us. Herb, you want to tell us what we got?
Yes, I will. Thank you, Nikki. What we've got is probably one of the key elements of the birding trail for this time of year, and it's the martin colony that you see here. This is 16 nesting gourds for the birds. These birds fly in from Brazil in early February and into March and begin their nesting. Last year they nested with 73 baby birds hatched here. Right now we have about 65. That are hatched, some more are still in the eggs. These birds will stay here till about the middle of July. Then they will all gather away from here in roosting areas near Thames Ford, is one area, by the tens of thousands. When they leave here, the nest then will be vacated and they will stay together in this big flock for about 3 weeks feeding, and they can be seen on radar. The rain radars see these birds when they leave in the morning, they fan out and create large areas where there's thousands of birds flying. They come back to those in the evening and start again the next morning. Then they get the signal, they all fly back to Brazil with the babies. And then that cycle starts over again. Brian Naughton is the volunteer that sponsors this colony, which is a major scientific element of the garden. This is bird conservation, probably at its fullest. Brian keeps records on every nest, counts the eggs, the babies, knows exactly what the production is each year, and then in the fall takes this nest down, cleans them all out and stores them for the winter, and then in February when the birds are coming back in from Brazil, he puts them back up. You notice there's 16 gourds here, I mean 16 nests. These birds have become dependent on man-made homes, as you see here. This particular design is by Brian Naughton. He developed this to keep other birds out that would kill these birds and take over their nests, like starlings and house sparrows, mainly starlings. So this is a very successful colony that's watched closely, and records have been kept on this for probably tens of years that Brian's been doing this. So we have a major treat here for bird conservation that is demonstrated just in this one colony of birds. So they are nesting here now. The ones you see are mainly the young ones. The parents have gone out to catch insects. You will see them coming back periodically, and they fly at altitude of 500 to 1,000 feet to feed. So there's a myth about them. They do not eat mosquitoes for a regular diet.
I'm so disappointed.
They feed at much higher elevation than where mosquitoes are. Mosquitoes are down 4 or 5 feet in the bushes. You watch these birds, they're always flying up high. So they're catching a lot of the food that migrates through here, like dragonflies. And if you watch closely, you'll see them come in with a big dragonfly in their mouth, go into the nest and feed the baby on the nest. So this is a great place to come and entertain your children. If you sit behind the fence over here in the children's garden and watch this colony, you can be entertained for 30 minutes to an hour watching them come and go. The best time is early morning, that's before they leave out. They're all around the nest, and then the afternoon about 4 or 5, they all come back. That's when the most birds are here. And it is such a treat to have this, being sponsored by Brian. And it's a lot of work that he does, and is to be commended for his conservation of birding. So this is a garden treat, an element of the birding trail that I am so proud of, that we've got a person to volunteer and do a colony like this.
Thank you for joining us for Garden Chat, and we'll be keeping you up on more information on the birding trail later on.